In this video, we are going to discuss about Bode plot of the integral factor or integral term. So you can see Bode plot for integral factor. We already discussed a list of basic terms to calculate or to draw the Bode plot. So in that, the second term is integral term. So integral term will be in the form of k by s or k by s power n. So first we will draw Bode plot for this integral term, and after that we will see about this. So now to draw the Bode plot for integral term means, first of all, the meaning to draw Bode plot for integral term k by s means the open loop transfer function is equivalent to that integral term. So here, first of all, g of s is equivalent to k by s. Our first step is to consider s is equivalent to j omega. Why? Because to draw any Bode plot, you require your open loop transfer function must be in frequency domain. But here you are having in s domain. To convert into frequency domain, you need to substitute s is equivalent to j omega. So that means, so here I am considering let s is equivalent to j omega, then that implies g of j omega is equivalent to k by j omega. Now this is the time to calculate magnitude and phase. Why? Because we already discussed about Bode plot, which is the combination of magnitude and phase plots. In both magnitude and phase plots, the x axis is similar, nothing but angular frequency, and y axis only is having difference. For magnitude plot, the gain in dB or magnitude in dB will be the y axis for magnitude plot, and for y axis of phase plot, that will be phase angle of the open loop transfer function. So for that purpose, I am going to calculate both magnitude or gain in dB and phase angle. So here, to calculate gain in dB, so to calculate gain in dB or magnitude in dB, so you need to calculate 20 log modulus of g of j omega. From this, if this is g of j omega, modulus of j omega will be the magnitude of this function. Magnitude means we won't get this j. So here k by omega will be modulus of j omega. So now here I am going to substitute that value, and that means this is equivalent to 20 log modulus of j omega place I am going to substitute k by omega. I am just substituting this value. So this is my gain in dB as well as magnitude in dB. Coming to phase phi, phase angle phi. So this is nothing but angle of j omega. I already given an equation for this in the previous video. Tan inverse imaginary part by real part. So if you consider this, if you consider this open loop transfer function, in this you are having imaginary part. You are having imaginary part, but you are not having real part. Whatever j multiples are there, those are called as imaginary parts. Is there any real parts in your equation? Means in your open loop transfer function equation, you are not having any real terms. So you are having imaginary term, but you are not having a real term. So tan inverse imaginary by 0 means, so you are going to get infinity. So tan inverse infinity is nothing but 90 degrees, but here you need to consider minus 90 degrees because your frequency is in denominator. So minus 90 degrees will be your phase angle. So now I am having my phase angle and I am having my equation to calculate magnitude, then I can draw my Bode plot. So this is my Bode plot. First of all, I need to consider omega, and omega, this is phi, and here this is minus 90 degrees. So phase angle will be minus 90 degrees. You need to draw like this. You need to indicate like this generally. For all omega, for all the values of omega, your phi value, your phase angle will be minus 90 only. So here this is phase plot. So up to here this is phase plot. So coming to magnitude plot, so here you need to consider gain in dB, gain in dB or m in dB you need to consider. So you are having equation for that, but you don't know the exact values to place. So that's why you need to consider the values. You need to consider the values for omega and you need to calculate the values and you need to put that values in that graph to get the exact structure of that Bode plot for the integral term. So now here I'm going to consider omega as 0.1k and omega as k and omega as 10k. These three values I want to consider. Consider a tabular form. So m in dB omega and m in dB. For example, if your omega is equivalent to 0.1k, what will happen? You can see 20 log. So here you can see in this equation you just substitute omega is equivalent to 0.1k. So I am just using here. If you substituted 20 log 0.1k means, so k by k will gets cancelled and you are going to get 1 by 0.1. So here 20 log, this is already base 10, 1 by 0.1. 1 by 0.1 means this is equivalent to, you can consider this as 10. So log 10 base 10, that is equivalent to 1. So you will get 20 dB. So now the magnitude or gain for omega is equivalent to 0.1k, it will be 20 dB. Now we can see the another value. This is first value. This is first value. Second substitution, I want to consider at omega is equivalent to k. At omega is equivalent to k, this magnitude is equivalent to 20 log 10 k by k. In omega, in place of omega, I am substituting just k. Then what will happen? You are going to get k by k is equivalent to 1, log 1 base 10. Log 1 base 10 means, so 20 into 0, you are going to get 0 dB. Third substitution, third value, like this you can take as your wish. Not only these values, I'm just taking simple values. Which values will gives me simple calculation, that values I'm considering. For example, if examiner given some values, that values you need to consider and by using calc you need to calculate. So here this is equivalent to 20 log 10, always log base is 10. Without mentioning this 10 also, you need to keep in mind when you are calculating magnitude, your base is equivalent to 10. So now 20 log 10, in place of this, so you need to substitute k by 10k. So my third substitution is omega is equivalent to 10k. If I substituted 10k here, kk gets cancelled. And here I will get 1 by 10. 1 by 10 means I can consider this as 10 inverse, log 10, 10 inverse. This inverse I can send to here, that means minus 20. Again log 10 base 10 is equivalent to 1. So you will get minus 20 dB. So now here I am going to draw. So at 0.1, at 0.1k, so this is equivalent to 20 dB. So for example, here I am having 20 dB and here I am having minus 20 dB. So these are the scales I am having at 0.1 k. So we got 20 dB. So that means I got my point here, my magnitude point there. And after that, for k, if you consider your angular frequency as 0, then your magnitude of your open loop transfer function will lie at 0. And for example, if you consider your angular frequency as 10k, then definitely your magnitude will decrease to minus 20 dB. So by combining all these three points, you are going to get the structure of your Bode plot. Magnitude plot combined with phase plot. So this is your Bode plot for the integral factor. So here the slope is minus 20 dB. Same thing we can write minus 6 dB by octave also. So in terms of slope 20 dB by decade, we can convert into minus 6 dB by octave. So like that also we can represent. The slope is 20 dB there. The slope of this Bode plot will be equal into minus 20 dB per decade. So here same analysis we can do for another integral term. Same analysis I want to do for another integral term. So that integral term is k by s power n. So here I am using another color to differentiate. So what we need to do? So in this case, in place of g of s, I need to consider k by s power n. After substituting s is equal into j omega to convert into frequency domain. So my value will be k by j omega whole power n. K by j omega whole power n. And here I am going to get k by omega power n modulus of j omega. This is g of j omega. This one is g of j omega. That means after substituting j omega in place of s, my open loop transfer function will turns to k by j omega whole power n. Now this is time to calculate the magnitude. So that is k by omega power n. Only we need to consider, only we need to consider, don't take equal to, so you can confuse. This is for this term, whatever I am writing with red color ink, that is for this term. I am doing another procedure. This one is completed. K by s is completed. The Bode plot for k by s is like that. Here I am going to draw Bode plot for k by s power n. Similar procedure I am doing. So here after calculating magnitude, j term will go away and I am getting only k by omega power n. And now gain in dB I need to calculate. How I need to calculate gain in dB means we are having formula 20 log modulus of j omega. So 20 log k by, so we need to consider m in dB is equal to 20 log modulus of j omega is equal to k by omega power n. This thing I am writing like this, k power 1 by n whole power n. I am considering like this, k power 1 by n divided by omega whole power n. If you consider like this, if you expanded this, you are going to get k by omega power n only. So this n I am sending here front side. So 20 n log k power 1 by n divided by omega. And here phase will be equal to minus 90 degrees only. Why? Because here also imaginary tan inverse, imaginary value divided by real value will be infinity. In this term also I am not having any real term. So that's why tan inverse imaginary term by 0 will be there. So definitely we are getting tan inverse infinity. As frequency term is in denominator, we will consider minus 90 degrees. The phase plot will be same. Coming to magnitude plot, the magnitude of the integral term k by s power n will be like this. Now I am going to substitute my feasible values. So that values are omega is equivalent to 0.1 k power 1 by n, omega is equivalent to k power 1 by n, omega is equivalent to 10 k power 1 by n. If you substituted these values, you are going to get same magnitudes, that means plus 20 dB. So in this case you will get m is equivalent to plus 20 dB. Why? Because if you substituted 0.1 k power 1 by n, k power 1 by n, 1 by n gets cancelled, and you are going to get log 10 base 10, you are going to get 20 n. Like that. So here the magnitude will be equivalent to 0. Why? Because if you substituted k power 1 by n, log 1 will be there. Log 1 means 0. 0 into anything 0. So here if you substituted 10 into k power 1 by n, then you are going to get 20 n log of 1 by 10 will get. So that's why 1 by 10 we can write it as 10 inverse like this. So that's why I am going to get 20 n dB. So these are the values you are going to get in terms of integral term k by s power n or k by j omega whole power n. So whatever it may be, you are going to get the same structure, but you are going to vary this magnitude values in that plot of k by s power n. Same plot, you just replace 20 ndb minus 20 ndb. Phase plot is same, only magnitude plot, magnitude values will change in that plot, and here the axis values will change like 0.1 k power 1 by n, k power 1 by n, 10 k power 1 by n. That's only the change. But whatever you are having, whatever slope, whatever structure you are having for that Bode plot, so that will be same for both integral terms k by j omega or k by s, or k by s power n or k by j omega whole power n. Like this, we need to draw Bode plot for the integral terms k by s and k by s power n.